I designed this mini wicking planter to fit a very tight space. When propagating ground cover plants, how do you know plants need watered if you can't see the soil surface? This system takes out the guesswork, and it saves a lot of time in the end. I'll show you how my prototype works. We'll see a simple, low-cost version that's easy to build. I'll discuss these wicking cords and potting mix options as well. What's the concept behind this wicking planter? The watertight lining holds gallons of water. The rails suspend pots above the water reservoir. A wicking cord automatically draws up water. There's no top watering. This self-watering system maintains a steady, constant supply of water. If you've read my book, you understand how all growth parameters need to be in balance. Do your plants have enough nutrients? A warm environment? Lots of light? Then this type of planter helps plants to grow and grow without ever needing to slow down to conserve water. To design a system like this, where do you start? It all comes down to the pots. I wanted 3.5 inches so my ground covers could spread out. I also wanted pots with a well-defined upper lip. This notched lip allows pots to rest on their support rails. This width determines the space between the rails. For these pots, that was 3 3/16 of an inch. Once I found the right gap, everything else came together. This prototype perfectly fits 4 rows of 7 pots. The entire project was built from old wood scraps. Even the pond liner is a scrap from my latest SIP build. That's a future video. But I folded in and secured the liner, and that was that. This is a lot of table saw work. Isn't there a simpler way to do this? Yes, here's a much easier version that's also super cheap. To start, you can buy a plastic storage bin for 10 bucks. Then, if you manage to find 2 straight furring strips, you have all the wood you need. No ripping, just some cross cuts. This version holds 24 pots. You can easily lift this top part off and set it down. The wet cords will drip water, but I found the pots fit perfectly in one of these Garland XL garden trays. Here's the tutorial for building this wicking planter. You'll need a miter saw, drill, driver, and some clamps. You'll only need 2 8-foot boards. Here are all of the board cuts. For assembly, I used corner clamps to fasten 3 of the outer boards. Then I inserted spacer blocks, a support rail, and so on until the last board is in place. The spacer blocks create a perfect gap. By clamping the boards, it's easy to secure it all with drywall screws. Just be sure to drill pilot holes because furring strips tend to split. Once the top was assembled, I turned it upside down and attached these legs. This is the only scrap left over, but you can use these pieces to secure the top so it won't slide off, leaving you with this. These pots fit nice and snug. But what's the deal with these wick pieces? For these wicking pots, I used shoelaces running through 2 holes in the bottom. You can use derby rope like this, or you could try cotton or hemp if you prefer natural materials. To conserve cord, you can snip a small hole in the pot. Cut the wicking cord at 12-inch lengths, then insert it with a knot on the inside. Snug, not overly tight. The knot should stop the wick from pulling out. Leave about 2 inches on the top for good wicking. You could just run the cord up into the pot, but the plant roots embed themselves into it, so this method creates less root disturbance. What are good materials to use in a wicking potting mix? Peat moss, coir, and vermiculite are all good at absorbing water. You can also add extra perlite for enhanced pore spacing and aeration. For this project, I used a standard potting mix. Then I added vermiculite, perlite, and a little extra fertilizer to round things out. Gently but firmly pack the pots with the mix to ensure good wicking action. In just a few weeks, these plants have completely filled out the pots. You can see roots at the bottom, even along the wicking cord. At planting time, just pop out the plant and tug on the wick to remove it. It's not a problem to break off a few fine plant roots. You could even snip those roots to release the cord. These wicks can be dried, cleaned off, and reused again. I've been really happy with the results from this system. It cuts down on watering while supporting higher light levels. I hope this gives you ideas to help with your indoor gardening. Thanks for taking time to watch. I really appreciate your support on my channel, and I'd like to wish you happy gardening.